New York.
The playoff hockey in the NHL is the best there is in sports. And as we're seeing through our playoffs this year, it's just been phenomenal. What we did for the regular season was spice up overtime a little bit. The 4-on-4, I don't believe, would work as well without the revised point system, but we play sudden death in the playoffs, and we like the game the way it is.
Now, Lester Patrick, the Hall of Famer, once said that hockey is a game of mistakes, and obviously we see this all the time, but a mistake was made in the Philadelphia-Buffalo game. A puck went in the net on the side. We'll take a look at it. This was the play here, and obviously it wasn't known at the time. They counted a goal, and a while later we saw the video, ESPN. My question to you is, do you admit that a mistake was made by the league?
You know what's interesting about your question, and I love the way you posit questions. This season, including playoffs, somewhere around 6,000 goals will be scored. Our replay system is excellent, works very, very well, and we probably get it right 99.99% of the time, but there's no system on the face of the earth that could get it right 100% of the time. There's no such guarantee. That goal that you just showed, when you looked at the first replay, you couldn't tell that it went in through the side, and in fact, it took 52 seconds for the puck to get dropped. Nobody in the building, I was sitting in the building, nobody on the Buffalo bench, Dominic Hasek, the officials, nobody thought that anything was out of the ordinary and that the puck had gone in and been scored. There were four broadcasters with 15 cameras, 15 tape machines, and 6 or 8 technicians reviewing tape. It took them 4.5 minutes to figure out that the puck went in through the side. There's no replay system in any sport unless you want to start calling back every offsides and everything else that would work. It was unfortunate that it happened, but there was nothing wrong with the system. It just happened.
Now, say 5-6 minutes after you discover that the mistake was made, what's the problem in terms of maintaining the integrity of the game to say, well, we now realize it's no goal, take it away. Why can't you do that?
We could be playing games all night. If a goal was scored on an offsides play and they discover it 10 minutes later, you can't. Once there has to be a finality to what happens. The referees make judgment calls all the time. There has to be a finality. We get it right with greater certainty than we ever get credit for and the officials ever get credit for. Slow down. If you want to ask a question, let me answer it. And the fact is, we waited 52 seconds. If anybody had suspected that there was anything wrong, anybody, then they would have taken their time, they would have looked at all the replay angles, and they would have waited the 4.5 minutes, but we waited almost a minute. It looked fine to everybody, and frankly, if you have to wait 4.5 minutes, that's no good for the game. You remember the crease rule last year? If you rely too much on videotape, it takes the excitement out of the game. You know what? Human beings play this game, human beings officiate the game, and human beings occasionally make mistakes.
Why couldn't your people in the booth have the same technology that enabled ESPN to find this?
Stan, you're not listening to me. Four broadcasters, 15 cameras, 15 replay machines, 6 technicians, 4.5 minutes. Do you want to slow this game down to a crawl and play 6-hour games, or do you want to play hockey? And out of 6,000 goals getting scored, if this happens a handful or less times, you have to live with it. There's no perfection, you know that.
All I want is the integrity of the game to be upheld, and so many people were questioned about it, but we accept your answer. Thank you for coming. We'll have more right after this break. Doc and Chico with highlights of the first period. Panthers leading 1-0.